All right, I'm just going to sneak in a couple more donations here while we're getting set up. We got $50 from Red Edward. Always fun to watch. I know my better half wants to save the animals. We've got $100 from Derek Star. First found AGDQ last year, been loving it ever since. Watching my favorite game get broken so I can donate during Fallout 3. Oh, and save the animals. Got $30 from Wheelio116. Hey, Bubbles, it's Wheelio, and I just wanted to say good luck to you on Fallout 3 and Oblivion. 87 years
ago. Yeah, I want that to happen. For
$25 towards Radiotron. Love Fallout. Have some love from the UK. Insane week so far.
How good can we get this? This is looking real nice.
Yeah, very beautiful.
Ooh, mouth. That's a good one to work. Ooh. I think we can work on color. Oh, here we go. Nice. That's pretty. I think we found our face. All right. What's the character name? For Oblivion?
I'll look it up here quick. It's Dolan PLS, so Dolan, please.
Dolan, please.
Yep.
All right, I need to choose the female high elf because they're the tallest, and the tallest characters are the fastest.
Mm-hmm. Their scale is a 1.1 versus 1.0 for most other characters, so they just run faster because Bethesda.
And speaking of 1.1 and 1.0, I am playing on version 1.0, so I can do a glitch for duplicating with arrows, and that'll save roughly a minute over the route in a weird way. And we'll get into that later. We'll talk about duping as it happens, and we'll talk about everything as it happens, but just sit back and enjoy. A lot of stuff's gonna happen pretty quickly after I leave the sewers. Timing starts when I hit this continue button right here. Fun Cannon's gonna control the timer. He's a pretty good runner of this game. He is gonna help me out with commentary here along with, oh, I guess we could do a roll call. I'm BubblesDelFuego. Say your names.
I'm Dr. T-Chops.
It's Dr. T-Chops.
I'm the Fun Cannon.
I'm Puri Puri.
Puri Puri.
I'm Shadex.
Shadex. Shoutouts to Shadex. they're all ran this game or associated with this game in some way. I'm not sure about Chops. Puri does anthology runs right, where he focuses on any percent, which hopefully you'll see after this if the donation is met. So please get in your donations for any percent to be ran. Shadex used to do runs of this for, I think, both categories.
Yeah.
Long ago, and TFC and I are the most current, up-to-date runners of this game, where we kind of go back and forth on the record. He currently has the record. He just got it back again. And here we go. Time starts in 3, 2, 1, go. Gonna immediately bind heal minor wounds and heal minor wounds. Heal minor wounds and flare.
Where's your dignity now, huh? Where's that famous high elf poise and flare?
You know, why am I not?
Did you reset your keybinds from yesterday?
Pretty soon I'll be free, and you'll.
So you might be noticing that there's an FPS counter in the top left. That's because the game runs really, really weird if you have a higher frame rate than that. So we cap it there. It'll basically run faster if mm-hmm. it's uncapped.
And it just becomes a pay-to-win battle.
We can start the timer.
The, best
yep.
Just pause the timer, I guess.
So it is not an error that it's up there.
I think if you hit it, it'll pause it. Yeah. Okay. World record. I need to have that bound. It happened last time. I should have remembered to do this, but it's okay. You guys can see what I'm binding, which is super exciting. Jump, auto move. I need a ready weapon to be, or weight to be R.
Yeah, that's over there.
Where was that?
Did you mean to pause the timer?
Yes. Strats. Weight is R. F is third person. Sneak is shift. And always run. Is that caps? Okay. Just got to make sure that I don't have to go in there again.
We'll still be stuck in this rat.
Timer resumed. All right, so I'm just stuck in here in the cell for a little while. I've got these things bound, flare and heal minor wounds. I need to heal throughout the run so I don't die, which is pretty important. Well, I'll be at low health definitely at some point. I am so glowy.
Your hands are glorious.
Just standing in the moonlight.
Just a god. So it's just me in this cell along with the famous rapper 2 Chainz. And this is the urn.
It's clearly a jug.
It is actually a jug.
Fine. I'll try to go bowling, but it's kind of hard to set up the cup. Okay, I get one shot at this.
I know it.
My job right now.
Hey! Yeah, okay.
Never mind. Get that gate open.
Right. Very rude, and we like to hit our guards before they show up.
If he's aggroed at me, he'll run at me. And if he runs, that's faster than walking.
Mm-hmm. So it takes 5 hits for them to actually aggro onto you.
That's the first hit.
Preps it right there so we don't have to do it after.
Why am I in jail? Oh, yeah, we start as a prisoner, just like every other Elder Scrolls game.
Except Daggerfall.
Yeah, except Daggerfall. Just don't play that, though.
Better not close this one. There's no way to open it from the other side.
I'm out of patience with you, prisoner. Oh, excuse me. And now they don't like us immediately. And we're gonna suddenly become their best friend again.
All you have to do is say sorry, and they just forget about it.
They're pretty fickle.
You'll notice something he's doing here is he's actually guarding before he's casting his spell, and that actually reduces part of the animation.
To confuse the Zelda community, I want to call it the ISG, the instant spell glitch.
So you can just get more spells off per minute, I guess.
That's Reynolds. Rest in peace.
Yeah, she didn't actually get hit or anything. She just kind of took a nap.
To hit this guy a few times, it's pretty important.
Again, to prep for later.
I got rid of the fatigue notification. You don't have to do that. I just like to. It's slow. I don't know why I do it. Waiting for the swell to fall. That was okay. It normally can take forever. I really need to get these enemies' things. I need potions, lockpicks, the key for this door, 2 different scrolls, and the potion of sorcery. Or I already said potion. So, and the arrows, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So that's that. And this is actually the slowest part of the run, even though it's pretty quick. Everything happens really quickly. It's the one part of the run where I'm going to be moving the slowest. So we're going to get our speed boost juice later on. But I don't want to spoil that right now. You guys will really enjoy it. But yeah, this is why we choose high elf female, because their walking speed is really good. I'm actually currently on like the always run, which I just bind to caps so you can like just turn that on and off. And change your running speed. I always make sure to have flare equipped so these rats in the hallway can get cooked.
Otherwise, they will block you forever.
Yeah, they're really annoying. And some more just basic section, walking by almost every enemy that we don't have to kill. Unless they're in our way, and then we're gonna get boom headshot. Do-ka-da-do. This guy, please get hit.
Nice.
That's the best. Can always just have some more fun. It's basic tutorial right here. Little gap jump to save a little bit of time. And immediately we'll be right back in the swing of things with our good old friends, the Emperor and his guards. And I still want to have flare equipped because there's a couple enemies that I have to kill up here. And this is really careful manipulation of enemies, and Fun Cannon can describe it while I focus.
Mm-hmm. So basically, since we hit Boris here earlier, he'll already aggro onto you, And we're aggroing on to him now so that the enemies that are going to be coming up later already start running towards us. And now he's going to de-aggro them so the final three don't actually make it very far. So they just kind of freeze in place. And then from there, it's just kind of finish these three off and talk to the Emperor.
Got to choose the steed because it gives you the speed attribute bonus. Come on. And now the Emperor is following him. Aggro him. I'm going to go the same path that they have to go. Like, they can't jump down cliffs, so I don't want to jump down the cliffs, or else they'll have to have the zigzaggy motion of movement. And now that I'm in here, these guys don't see me yet because their trigger for being active enemies isn't happening. I want to de-aggro him when he's standing right about here. And then
you may as well
get the item for this guy so he doesn't take his time coming through this door. And now I'm in this room. And I'm going to be doing a lot of duplicating in this room. And Funkhand is going to explain that again because I also have to focus.
Mm-hmm. Hold up. All right, so basically, for arrows and scrolls, they are kind of special in your inventory. And the arrows only work on the current patch that we're using, 1.0 or 1.1, not the Steam version, which is 1.2. So basically what he's doing is he's activating some sort of action, whether it be an attack or a spell or something like that. And then he double-clicks the arrows so that they get stored by the game for whatever reason, whenever you actually equip them. And then from there, he drops something else of lesser value, and it will drop the number of arrows that were stored of the other item. And the same thing is happens with the scrolls here, except the scrolls don't need an attack to actually, you know, do. Well, we're getting a lot of keys now.
Oh no.
So
the game doesn't like it when you do
it
this.
It really doesn't.
I'm just going to do exactly what I did right there over here.
Good idea. So the scrolls are really what we want to be using to dupe since they don't take a lesser action. And so you can do it over and over. And we need the 300 scrolls that he has there for flashbolts simply because...
We'll get there.
This is a 3-frame rate right now.
We're going to need flashbolts for the rest of the run because they're stronger than firebolts.
2-frame rate.
Yeah, we don't really use weapons throughout the run at all. Mm-hmm. We use stupid. Now it's pretty much just flashbolt.
1-frame rate.
There we go.
We made it. Yay.
And we also need lockpicks for later because there's plenty of places that we need to just force our way through doors.
If I did the duping correctly earlier, I could have aggroed these guys a little sooner. But now they're running at me, which is a little bit faster than their little strut. He's pushing the Emperor, which is really nice of them.
It is.
And the Emperor's in the perfect spot now, okay. And I've got plenty of lockpicks, I think. And I want to have... I made sure to bind Flashbolt to the 2-key now. It doesn't matter what you bind to. But 2-key. So now that's going to be my main damage source of the run. That's rude.
I can go.
Don't worry, he just falls over.
And this is the main assassin. Always whiffs his first attack. He has one job. All he does is stand there. Now we're going to work on leaving. And it barely matters, but Monk and Nightblade are pretty good to choose because of their things off that they can start off with for... like attribute bonuses.
They've got the speed and other things like that that just make it perfect for speedrunning. Anything that you would make a custom class for basically would become Nightblade, so may as well just pick Nightblade.
By the way, this is the no out of bounds category, which means I will not be going out of bounds.
Hopefully.
No OOB. I'll stay my best to stay in bounds. I'm not really an oob man myself. Funcannon loves oobs. I'm not really like oobs. We'll see plenty of oobs later. Some sweet oobs, some really big oobs. Okay, immediately fast travel to the Chestnut Handy Stables.
There's a special guy just hanging around the corner, and he's pretty friendly, actually.
Yeah, he's actually, like, the nicest drug dealer I've ever seen. Not saying that I've, like, seen a lot of drug dealers, but, like...
Well, this guy's up there, we'll put it that
way. He's in, like, the top 5 drug dealers that I've ever talked to.
You need something, let's do business.
Alright, so I'm going to sell the potions that I got. That's a lot of lockpicks, that's good for the run. Buy this skooma. And this is where things get fun. Go into the Wayne and Priory.
Basically, skooma fortifies your speed anytime that you drink it.
And this is your brain. And this is your brain on skooma. That'll
we need
good.
Probably about 500 to 600 at bare minimum for the entire run. So.
And you can see in the top left that he's encumbered, but all, Skooma also makes you very strong, which is good because we have to carry, like, you know, 1,000 spells and all these other items.
And now we're fast.
And that was only 5 Skooma.
It's the typical max that the game tries to keep you at for any sort of potions, but there's a way to get past that.
Yeah, they didn't do a good job at that.
So you saw me hotkey it, which makes sense, so I don't have to go in my inventory. But I'm gonna go in my inventory anyway and have 4 from the hotkey and 4 from the inventory, so now we have 8 Skooma at the same time, which is the highest that you can possibly move in the game. And even if you use console commands, you can't move this fast. I've tried for testing, so for like save files and whatnot. So this is fast as we can. We're immediately going to make our way to Miskarkand, which makes no sense.
Typically, you're supposed to go to Kvatch right after talking to Jeffrey.
Because they tell you to. Yeah, we call him Jeffrey. You know it's Joffrey.
He doesn't deserve that.
Yeah, he can be annoying.
But basically, this is kind of an intended sequence break by the game, where you can grab one of the Welkin Stones way earlier than you're supposed to, and later Martin will basically say, hey, you already have that Welkin Stone. So it was completely intentional for you to walk in here and get this early.
When I descend down staircases, you'll see me like stutter a little bit. I'm just being careful so I don't take massive fall damage. That's the biggest risk in this run, is dying from environment and fall damage.
Mm-hmm.
And right here, my first Skooma jump of the game. Ooh. Oh.
Almost.
I'll get it.
He also has to be careful to not apply an extra Skooma, or else a little dialogue message will pop up that'll lose a bit of time.
If you go up to 5, then you can never get up to 8, basically.
Yeah, and then you'll have to wait for them to wear off, so you'll also lose that time where you wouldn't have that extra 3 Skooma applied.
And basically, Skooma jumping is just kind of bouncing off an item, more or less, and since it just kind of transfers all your speed from horizontal to vertical, with Skooma, you kind of go very, very high.
You get really high.
It's also bad because the way this game handles speed and objects in sometimes, not always, but you might see them go out of bounds at one point. There's this thing called momentum clipping, where you can literally just run through a wall because the object isn't fully loaded and you're going so fast.
It was a good thing I wasn't talking there because I really needed to focus. That was the first boss of the game, by the way.
Takes exactly 1 firebolt or flashbolt.
If you're lucky. Sometimes you can power up and it'll take a whopping 2.
If he reflects it, yeah.
Yeah. And he also spawned 2 zombie enemies, and they follow me for the remainder of the game. If I go to jail and I come out of jail, which can happen in a run if you accidentally hit an NPC.
You also noticed that he had a bunch of enemies following him in the dungeon, and normally you wouldn't be able to fast travel, but right when he exited, what he did is he twitch-saved, he twitch-loaded, and that actually despawns the aggro for a bit, and then you can fast travel.
Yeah, it only works for enemies that are behind a door, like, that you just left, so that's why I had to kill the goblins on the outside before I entered the building, so they wouldn't bother me. This run can be really annoying compared to Fallout for when it comes to aggroing enemies. I'm gonna go for this. I might be stupid.
It looks like it's...
Okay.
Yeah, that was close. So if your Skooma falls, like...
Yeah, you can stop.
So if your Skooma stops and you run out while you're in midair, you won't, like, continue your movement. You'll just fall down and stop. And if you do that over lava, you're dead.
If you make any mistakes in the movement for there, you're pretty much going to fall in the lava.
All right. You'll see... One of the coolest new skips of the game, which I'm actually pretty consistent at, doesn't mean it's easy.
It's probably the hardest one.
Called another Skooma jump, but it's just like, it seems it speaks for itself. It skips a key.
Mm-hmm.
First try.
Nice. So only one of the doors is locked because you're not supposed to be able to make it over there.
Got the Skooma continuation in a small frame window there.
Very nice.
And because we have so many lockpicks, we can just auto-attempt.
Mm-hmm. It's faster just to force your way through than try and actually do everything. And then each time you get into the Oblivion Gate, there's a Skooma jump that you can do that he just did to get up the chapel here earlier.
And if you fall down like he's doing right here, it'll trigger the ending a bit quicker.
Mm-hmm.
So now we need to go save Martin from the ambush that is inside the city. Or by the church. And if you think it wastes time going into the menu to get Skooma, we don't always go into the menu to get an 8 stack. But it really makes a huge difference. If you accidentally use 5 on the outside and then go in the menu, that's a big waste of time because of the menu time and the fact that we're much slower. This guy up here is really annoying to hit sometimes. Okay, that was good.
Very nice.
Yeah, you have to be very careful to not attack allies, or else you can kill them and you will go to jail, mm-hmm. which is obviously not ideal. Ugh.
See, right here I'm only going to use 5 Skooma, so I don't have to go in the inventory, because all I have to do is talk to Martin and then leave and then fast travel.
Anytime you're trying to fast travel as well, if you're over encumbered, you also can't travel. So there are times when you kind of open the menu to travel and you just look stupid.
So normally right here you would go talk to Jeffrey, and he would tell you to check if the amulet's drawn, but you can just go straight to the amulet and then you'll skip that dialogue line. Saves like 20 seconds.
Also trying to skip the blacksmith from talking to you.
Yeah, I'll just forget about him.
Okay. Because it wastes time, and he is very persistent with trying to talk to you. You really need to know that the chapel is under attack, because you can't see it already.
He spawned a thing.
I don't think I've ever seen that.
I've never seen
that before. Marathon first. Anytime now. I don't want to accidentally shoot over there, because I can kill one of them, and that'll get me arrested.
Well, Martin can't die, but he'd
and it can also ruin a lot of in-game time problems because I have to have these guys follow me when I fast travel somewhere. Mm-hmm. There we go. Rippy dippy. Alright. Cloud Ruler Temple. Progressing the storyline, but I'm going to skip the Cloud Ruler Temple cutscene. That's sweet guzzling sounds. By entering Cloud Ruler Temple and immediately leaving and coming back later. But as I'm leaving, I might as well get some stuff done while I'm gone. And while I'm gone, I'm going to do another quest that you could do earlier, kind of intended, like the Miskarkand stone one. I need a Daedric item for the main storyline to proceed, and the quickest one to get is by getting the Umbra and trading in the Umbra to the Clavicus Vile Shrine. I got 2 humans, nice. It's terrible.
But, you actually get this Daedric artifact via a glitch because you're supposed to not be able to get it until level 25, but if you get the sword first before you actually get the quest, it doesn't actually check your level.
It thinks that the quest is over.
So
it doesn't have breaks in that sequence, so we break it for it.
You can also notice him being very cautious when you go downstairs. This is probably the most annoying place.
I'll take that. I love drugs. All right. Now, every time we use the flash bolt, since it's a scroll and they get used one at a time, I need to reuse the scroll and re-click the bind again. So every time I use flash bolt, I love it when I do that. Mm-hmm. Every time I use flash bolt, I get brought back to heal minor wounds. All right, so I need to talk to this cool cat.
You approach.
And do the dog butt skip.
Because for whatever reason, talking to the dog part of the statue skips all the dialogue.
That saves 25 seconds if you talk to the dog's butt.
Yep.
Bethesda.
It's only the dog's butt. Found by Ymiri Yams, an extremely good runner and glitch hunter and... made the current route, basically. And he kind of built it off Matumbra, who's an older record holder and very good player of this game's older route, where he played it on the current patch. Okay. I talked to the Amulet Kings, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So now I need to be very sneaky when I steal this guy's book, because now we're doing library quests, and we're trying to become the world's coolest librarian and get all these books.
He had to walk into the back corner so that the shopkeeper wouldn't actually notice him, because he's very, very nosy.
And you have to steal from him before you kill him, or else you'll get arrested.
Mm-hmm. There's a lot of movement, and this is probably the highest movement part of the game. Like, a lot of different things happening at once kind of movement. Mm-hmm. So I need to wait until a certain amount of time. So when I'm done talking to this person that I'm waiting for, I can also use this wait window for when a shop is open, because that's where I'm going afterwards. So like 8:43 is like a good time. Mm-hmm. And it lines up with everything else. Consume skill move before talking to her, so you can move afterwards.
It was so nice.
Back to the market district and inquire about some more books. I'm going to use 8 stack here just so I can have persistent skooma for when I fast travel later. Because it's a good chance that we can run out. Oh, whoops. That book. Sometimes it's really easy to click other things. Good. Leave, come back. This guy's here.
If you push him towards the desk, he actually starts talking a little faster.
He talks to him dependent on how far away he is from him. And he has a set path that he walks. That is delicious.
Ugh. And here we're actually supposed to be going and talking to Boris. However, if we go to talk to Boris first, then Boris will come in here and you have to escort him, and he will try and kill every single enemy that he can possibly see. So instead of that, we're going to be going all the way to the end and dropping aggro of all the enemies and waiting for Boris instead, so that he doesn't have to fight any enemies at all.
And I'm going to go for a skooma jump here. Black Wavy in the community actually found a lot of these, including this one. I want it.
There
you
go.
Oh, baby. That's the biggest time saver in the entire run, saving 2 seconds.
So all he does here then is goes through, I think he quick save, quick load, and then he waits, and then Boris will appear. But you can't talk to him while you're in this room. So after this, he's going to leave, and then I'll talk to him out here.
This is a point where you need to make sure that you're meeting the sponsor, or else it takes just a crazy extra amount of time.
And I hear footsteps. Or not, that's cool. Took a good guess, though. Sometimes you can hear his footsteps, sometimes you can't. Sometimes there's other noises going on. I honestly just couldn't hear the footsteps there. I was quiet enough. It's the only lock picking in the game. I hope you enjoyed it.
First try.
Yeah. It's really hard. Okay, I need de-aggro again because after killing that guy, all his buddies are after me, but not anymore. All right, and now I need to come to this place and interact with the shrine, which hopefully I'm there for. I'm not. I gotta wait just 1 hour. Mm-hmm. It's active between 11:47 a.m. and 12:30 p.m. I am over-cucumbered, so I need more skooma.
So if you actually get here at a really bad time, you'll have to like wait a certain amount of in-game time, mm-hmm. or travel somewhere else and then travel back.
Mm-hmm. And coming up is probably the best dialogue in the game.
Best dialogue, and also, I think, I don't know if I like this place more or Sanctuary more, but both places are extremely cool for movement.
I'd probably say this one.
Yeah, this one's an extremely tight-looking cave, and slightly walked in the wrong direction. It's okay. And you have to really memorize the map out, and it's really impressive on your first time through, but after a while when you just run, it's like super muscle memory-based, and it speaks for itself mostly. And it starts off with a great skooma jump, which, what did you name it, Chops?
The YOLO midair book wrap.
Yep. Even though, oh, whoops.
Duh.
Hi. Forgot about you. Bye.
We just need this key.
You kept me. Reminder that
yes,
you
I
cannot
can.
Escape the master's vigilance.
You cannot take on. You'll just hear both of those things a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, got it. No problem whatsoever. Okay.
Wasn't there.
But now my health is really low, so I'm going to be healing and running at the same time through this whole thing. And it's going to look crazy, but I know where to go. Don't worry. I hope. Now,
what are your thoughts on Lord Dagon?
Well, he's a pretty cool dude, I think.
I heard, but this isn't confirmed, that you cannot escape his vigilance.
Well,
Intriguing.
Bet you can't prove him wrong.
You can't. Hey, I found it.
Oh.
This is one of those occasions where I don't want to go into the menu because it would just be the same amount of time. Reduce my aggro. Leave. There might be a wolf nearby.
No, did you just escape his master's
vigilance? I did escape the master's vigilance.
Wow.
That deserves a clap.
Amazing.
So this is the part where we keep going back and forth to Cloud Ruler Temple, and these guys act really annoying on their spawns. Mostly Jeffrey.
Ah.
Ah. Hey, nice book that just appeared out of nowhere. I'm going to go stop some spies for him. Because we're really nice. And he's our best friend. We're going to wait until the spies are actually going to be in the same spot at the same time. Mm-hmm. Would 9-11 be a good time?
Yeah.
Okay, 9-11 a.m.
Basically, they just run on a schedule at all times. So we're waiting until they're all inside of the house at the same time so we can just housebreak and murder them all.
It's okay. They're spies. They're evil.
Have mercy.
No. Now, like I said earlier, we're going to do our best to not go out of bounds. This guy.
Oh, there's someone actually watching.
There we go. Flawless. I just imagine us jamming a piece of metal into these holes over and over at the speed of light until they decide to work. Good thing I got a lot of those. Mm-hmm. Yeah. What the? Nice arm. fast travel. Sometimes it's hard to remember when you have to fast travel, when you have to de-aggro and then fast travel. That horse has moved a solid 10 feet. All right. Joffrey Martin Joffrey again, but Joffrey is being a dork.
Yeah, it's annoying here because your quests are usually on the wrong quest, so you can't actually tell where they are.
What can I?
That's who I want to talk to.
And you have to go searching for them.
What have you? I will send word to the Countess.
This is where I hand in the Daedric artifact. So I got it. I had a good time. If I go over there, I swear he's going to be outside.
Yeah, just a second.
He's really good at avoiding you.
Yep, and he's back out. I've just.
All right, so now the next Oblivion Gate, second out of three Oblivion Gates that I visit within the game. This one is Bird. It's my least favorite.
The hardest, because there's nothing you can do. If Bird does not want to show up, he won't.
I have to make sure that he doesn't stay aggroed on certain enemies, and even if I do, sometimes he can still be aggroed on certain enemies and just not want to follow you. So start off with a jump across the lava, go up the slanted hill, and hold this direction to get up this slant and enter the building and keep reversing in and out.
Onward this is based.
To make him teleport.
Okay. Nice. So if you run to the last room of this, you can run straight there, like it's no problem. But if Bird isn't with you, the quest update won't trigger and you can't actually finish the great gate for this gate.
It's a great gate, mate. Alright. Now he'll appear again.
Yeah, so every time at the start of every time he enters a door, he just wants to do a quick check and make sure he's with them. Yeah.
Okay, I need to kill this guy.
Okay. Got him.
Good job, Bird.
You did something with your life for once.
I gotta go quickly up here so he doesn't aggro on one of these guys. And he should be here. Okay, there we're good. And right. Bird followed me all the way through.
Bird was based today.
And I'll get a little notification to let me know that I did okay at the video game. Totally worth it.
There it is.
Yeah, you can actually get a boost all the way up.
You can actually run out of skooma as you're falling down.
Or the dead body's going to teleport.
Yep.
Hey!
Oh, there we go.
It was an honor.
Shoutouts to Hanky. Okay, Joffrey Martin Joffrey again. What else can I do to help? Let me talk to this guy. It's like, you have to feed information back and forth to them, but, like, they're right next to each other, so why can't they just do that?
So
yeah.
Like a failing marriage, I guess.
Oh, too real. Right, now on the way to Sacrator, which is, it's a really fun place to move around in. But the closest place to fast travel from there is from that town, so I have to get to that north gate, leave, and just walk north-northeast until I get there. And unlike Fallout 3, you can fast travel to a lot of undiscovered locations, because I guess you already know they exist. We're assuming that this prisoner is from this area because of that.
So Sanctator is surrounded by skeletons, and because this is the overworld, you actually have to kill them if they spot you, or else you won't be able to use the quick save glitch to fast travel.
So once I get outside of Sanctator, I'm going to want to book it straight from the entrance as fast as possible, so I aggro as least as I can. If we have to actually bump into any, that's going to suck. Okay, so hopefully the skooma stack can lead me straight to the door and I won't have to worry about them. I'm going to go right through this crack right here.
Yeah, this dungeon used to be really bad because before we found the quick save quick load glitch, you would have to kill every enemy inside that saw you. And as you'll see, there are a ton of ghosts. And if you miss any, you wouldn't be able to fast travel after.
Spooky warning here. There's a lot of ghosts.
I'm going to close your eyes. Just getting them open. All right. Some solid movement. Always full stacking on skooma here. You can see me holding W for the entire time as I go down these ramps. There's no big deal here on taking fall damage. It's not really existent in most areas.
The main thing we have to do here is kill these four skeleton guys because they're ancient blades.
And there is a bit of randomness with them, depending on where they stand. You can attack them like really easily, or you might have to go down near them.
Mm-hmm. This first one is not too bad, but it's the next one that has more time loss associated with if you get bad RNG.
Oh. That ghost is normally halfway down that hallway. Alright, please be standing right out in the open so I don't have to come down. Okay.
Yeah, so that one's not too bad.
Mm-hmm. Maybe 2 or 3 seconds.
Yeah. I'm really confident in my things hitting them because you'll get a notification right here saying I did. And the fireballs and them have a huge hitbox, so you can even shoot like a foot away from them and I'll still hit them. Nice. Now here's the third one that we have to kill. Hopefully he's in a good spot because this guy wastes the most time.
He's just stopping.
So you can see he had to jump down and then run all the way up, back up here.
I want to focus on healing again. It's a very acrobatic area of the game. Another guy, last guy, and then I go right back to the final room. And I wait a little bit after de-aggroing from these ghosts. Uh-oh.
It was a little close.
Yep.
Running out of skooma can sometimes be very deadly.
You got a lot of things I gotta keep my eyes on the screen.
Yeah, so you wait here because everything operates on an in-game timer, and these guys need to get into a specific position, and you can just skip that if you just wait. Ah! And then you time this well so that the invisible barrier that blocks you, maybe.
Yeah. Okay, the good thing, we just loaded there.
Yeah, so there's an invisible barrier in there, and you have to time it so that, like, as soon as you get through there, it drops down, or else you'll be slow or die.
I waited a generous amount of time there.
Yeah, I don't know what was up with that one.
What?
Is it not triggering?
The other guy isn't here. Who did I not kill? Who goes in the far right spot?
Was it the first one?
I'll check.
pretty sure he killed all of them.
They look like it.
Yeah. Hmm.
Yeah, there's his remains.
Maybe the last one?
Whoops.
Do I have time to read a quick donation?
Definitely.
All right. Project DT88 donates $5 and says, I will make this pledge. I will donate an additional dollar for every minute underestimate the Oblivion runner gets on his run. If this comment is read, it will be $2 a minute.
That's a good thing to read.
No pressure.
Well.
I mean, never mind. I'm not going to jinx it.
Tesla games are always great at surprising you, no matter how many times you run them.
This has never happened to any runner.
Bethesda games are pretty famous for being very consistent and working very well in every marathon run ever.
I got the. I guess I just had to wait longer because I remember getting the notification for the second guy that I killed.
Yeah. We got them all.
I hope he's there.
I'll just wait again. Want me to no clip past that and get it and leave?
Probably,
I think so.
All right.
So this is like a never before seen soft lock, I guess, that no one has ever encountered ever.
We did it! Yay!
Nice. All right. This is just a glitch. Don't worry about it. It's fine.
Collision's back on, by the way. Don't worry.
It was never off.
All right. Anyway, forget about those few dollars that guy isn't going to give us now. I promise to go fast for the remainder. So now when I leave, I really hope there's no skeletons on the outside so I can fast travel, and I'm immediately going to do a quick save, quick load to Diagro. The one, oh, hello. And now I can come up here. Yep, that was pretty good for the skeletons not being around. I can really waste minutes. Back to normal. Now that Sankrator is done, we can head to the end game areas.
My pro.
So we got your armor, completely legitimately. A great.
And here's where the Miskarkin stone is being turned in from way back at the start of the run.
Yeah, so instead of handing everything in one by one like you would do in a normal playthrough, we can just route it all so that we can hand them in all at once and save a bunch of time.
And I'm preparing the battle for the final Oblivion Gate, where he gives like a big speech and all that.
Greeting.
Yeah, you don't have to close all the gates like some few people thought. You can just do those two.
Yeah, it's parkour. Ow.
You can very easily die there.
Mm-hmm. I will call.
M'lady. Please let me have Skooma. Okay. I'm gonna wait when I'm at the bottom of the hill. It's not a big difference maker.
Mm-mm.
But it's a little more consistent because in practice I waited at the top of the hill. Because you need to have your boy be down here, Martin.
And this begins the only auto-scroller of this run.
Yep.
Because there's no known way to speed this up, it being on a in-game timer.
You have enough time for two, maybe one long donation?
All right, we've got $50 from Anonymous. Looking forward to seeing Oblivion. What a beautiful character, too. We have $100 from LFQ Soon. Watching people gather for a great cause is always a fantastic sight. Keep up the good work and speed. $50 to killing the animals, $50 for Runner's Choice.
Runner's Choice. I'm putting that towards the Oblivion any percent. They all know that, but if you guys want to not put it towards... If you guys want to donate and see an extremely broken run of Oblivion, beaten in roughly 6 minutes on average, please donate to get that in. Fun Cannon behind me will be doing that run. I You only need to consume one skooma at a time here to move fast enough and to kill these guys with a 1-2 punch. But I want to have 5 skooma used all the time to reduce the amount of skooma in my inventory so I can reduce the weight. This whole section will be ruined if Martin dies. So we just want to make sure he's protected.
Nice arrow sticking out of his back.
He's fine.
Good thing he's wearing the armor we totally got legitimately.
The archers in this game are not really known for their accuracy. Here comes another one.
Get wrecked! Okay, how about you just go back? Don't give me that look.
And again, you'll notice a lot of the time he's aiming downwards towards the enemy's feet. That's so that he's,
well, bye, Boris.
That's so that you don't kill allies.
Nobody saw that. Nobody saw that. They can run in your way so easily. I've had Martin come in the way and hit him. Are you good? What's your health at? It's good. Okay. Where's Joffrey? Okay, we'll worry about that later. Okay. Simmer down. Two of you. It's my birthday.
They don't seem
I'm gonna
to fight
kill it. The guys that are around Martin. They're a priority. That's a lot of enemies. I feel like I've been killing them at a good rate as well. Okay, the final gate's opening. Hi! Okay. There we go. I got 8 sack before I come in here. I'll be moving nice and quickly. Make sure to quick save.
Yeah, you can die here if your skooma runs out in the lava, so it's really important that he did that there.
And we're going to be jumping across lava. This is supposed to be like the longest Oblivion gate in the game, but it's actually the shortest for the speedrun, please. And I got the minor skooma jump. It showed off the fact that it's possible.
Just drinking skooma midair.
Yep.
Don't worry about it.
Can't fast travel midair, you can't drop things midair, but you can take out a bottle of skooma and drink it midair.
Wonder where all the bottles go.
Yeah.
Don't ask questions.
Where'd the soda go? And we once again don't need keys because we are going to jam a stick of metal into the keyhole over and over again until the door works. There we go. And the final room again. Surprised. Oh. There we go. It's really hard, actually.
And that's the great gate.
Don't say that. I almost died there. Okay. All right. I'm going to want to kill this guy, actually. Oh.
Use the dead body as a shield!
Okay, they're not going to kill Martin because he's way back there and
he's stuck.
He's having fun, but he needs to die before I can fast travel. Just please kill him already.
You may. Okay, there we go.
We won.
Oh, I don't want to talk to you about Daedric magic. And now for the paradise and part of the game. Please be solid.
So okay, in practice yesterday, for whatever reason, Cloud Ruler Temple, when we got here, just didn't exist. We just walked through the stairs.
It was like an illusion. The idea of it was there, but just... And the guards were also, like, falling through the floor of it. Fine Cannon tweeted it. It was pretty good. Oops. So there's evidence of it out there, if you want to check that out. Okay, so I lined up the skooma timing for my 8 stack to be right before I entered, so I can
the cat's paw of the septic
collect this. Oops.
You didn't think you could take it unaware.
Sometimes when you enter this area, this guy won't actually spawn outside. But if that happens, you can just go ahead and enter the cave, and he'll just be waiting for you right before the door.
And I kill him because I need those gauntlets. I absolutely need them.
Look now upon my paradise.
To open up these red hot fiery doors.
Alata in the old tongue, a vision of the past. And the
It's the final boss talking to us right now. I'm really not smart.
Behold the savage god.
And I'm going to be jumping over lava. Like a risky person.
Where my disciples he actually killed that guy because destiny. If he does so, then he won't talk to you, and it will aggro the danger early to make the gate open.
Don't worry, that guy's fine.
And now he'll talk to me because I need his help.
I'm ready to help.
Big help. And this trick is hard. We hold down W.
Well done, champion. Your progress is swift and sure. Perhaps you will reach me after all.
And now we're going straight for the final boss.
You think I mock you?
With a little not free scuba all. Jump on the way out. So when you in jump in the coming, air and you hit like a right angle slant, kind of, you can get a scuba jump, like with the fire and the steps and the little nudges in the ground.
You
so the staircases
the
are basically free.
Decadent Tamriel.
It's awesome.
I
it
am
gets
the
us up there in a very linear
your
fashion.
Tamriel Reborn.
Kill one of these guys so they don't talk to you when you walk by them.
I welcome you.
Get the quick kill. And that was the final boss of the game.
Hard boss.
I tire of the self-spare heroes who set themselves in my path, only to be unworthy of the event.
That's what happens if you try to sit on this throne. It's really slippery. Hello.
Oh. You found a way.
All right, now just the ending of the game where we think everything is good and I killed the final bad guy and we're going to get Martin knighted into emperor status.
Because he did all the hard work.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Have you seen that helmet?
Yes. Everything is ready for Martin's arrival.
Looks like it.
I've been expecting.
That was actually pretty quick. He never talked to you that quickly. Oh, he's so far away.
Martin Septim. On behalf of the Elder Council,
all right.
I accept your
I hope you can see this guy from this far away. But the world is ending, and he's telling us about this terrible news.
Courage.
But he's got this huge smile on his face over there, I think.
What are your orders? Shall the guard fall?
No.
So what he's doing here is he's quick saving and quick loading during the dialogue lines, which speeds it up just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Which is also done in Skyrim.
Much more effective in Skyrim, but it still helps here.
And in Fallout, like I just did. So it's the same idea as earlier, if you remember my explanation when I was deep in, but it's basically when you reload it, you can't have dialogue happening there. It's only for like that one. Mm-hmm. Other dialogue, it doesn't really work. We don't worry, we tried. And even though there's enemies out there, we don't have to do the quick save quick load method here. Just wait an hour and then
we have two
buddies here. And get ready on time, Fun Cannon. You know what to do.
Mm-hmm.
Get over here and then get the best Sean Bean cutscene at the end of the game. And time. I'm over-cucumbered. He realized fire wasn't working on the fire monster.
I think he beats him with bad breath or something.
And Sean Bean just has to die in everything. That he's ever in. It's proven in Oblivion as well. We'll hear him in a second.
The amulet is shattered. Dagon is defeated. With the dragon's blood and the amulet of kings, we have sealed the gates of Oblivion forever. The last of the Septims passes now into history. I go gladly, for I know my sacrifice is not in vain. I take my place with my father and my father's fathers. The third age has ended, and a new age dawns. When the next Elder Scroll is written, you shall be its scribe. The shape of the future, the fate of the Empire. These things now belong to you.
And that was Oblivion, the Elder Scrolls IV Oblivion done without going out of bounds. Absolutely legitimately. Thank you for watching. I'm kind of scared to hear the results, but was any percent met? By how much?
We were at 58.24.
Ah, sorry. So, I don't know. If you guys want to see Oblivion any percent, though, please follow the fun canon. He also did Borderlands earlier. It's completely phonetic and there's no numbers. It's all one word. He's got the record and he's really amazing at it. And I'm going to be going for like a 34-minute in-game time on this when I get back home if you want to see more Oblivion. And if you want to go to speedrun.com/Oblivion, there's plenty of resources there. There's FAQ, tutorial, other runners. Talk to any of us and we'll help you out. And once again, for everybody here and everybody watching at home, thank you very much.
Thank you so much to Bubbles for that amazing Oblivion run. Coming up next is Dust Force DX with Callistus. There is a donation incentive for that also to play a super hard secret level. And that needs about 1,700 more to be able to meet that. So if you'd like to see him play a super hard secret level in Dust Force DX, who wouldn't want that? So get your donations in right away.